G'day guys, welcome to Lumber for a tournament game for the 1v1 Valkyrie mod. And we're here to see the ex-master, Mr.Pringles, as the Commonwealth, up against Flapajak, the competitive rookie who's been in one other tournament, didn't do too well in the previous one. He's gone as Japan down the center with an assault squad, and Pringles, obviously the favorite in this group, winning all tournaments before this, undefeated until the previous one to this, actually, versus Tedessa in a very close game. So he's the favorite to come out of this group. He's got an assault squad as UK, sending a lot to the right, also a recruit squad to the right as well. And Flapajak doing the exact same thing. These guys are playing a very different meta to the games I've casted so far. He's sending a recruit squad to the roadway. They're actually kind of evaded each other the way they charge in, and then fighting horizontally on the flag. Pringles got the stone wall. Flapajak moving away from the fire because he doesn't have the cover and is capping the flag still, as Flapajak is even running his guys all the way around, going to try to flank the guys behind the wall. Interesting play, and another recruit squad for Mr. Pringles. So the low tier is in fashion in Group B, it seems, as we have the recruit squad from Flapajak running in. Now they're going to engage the assault squad and also moving part of his assault squad up the hill. So just a bit of dancing around the map at the moment, and here comes the ambush from Pringles behind. Bam! Opens up on the UK assault squad, and Flapajak forced to flee with his recruit squad away from the fire. And as you can see, the left side, no one's actually capping it, and this is one little strat tip here. I always send three guys there just in case of this type of scenario, and it did happen in this game, so I would have done well there, as Mr. Pringles is capping the eastern point with three guys, so one flag apiece. Flapajak doing okay with the grenades, it seems. It's 8 all actually, so it's very even in kill counts. No one getting the advantage of each other, and grenades are not being thrown very well. Knocks down the hut, and finally one gets off as another recruit squad from Pringles. Not the same one, I'm not too sure, but let's see what he gets next. He's got another recruit squad, militia squad. And on the other end, Flapajak hasn't bought anything except... Oh yeah, he's got a machine gun. Interesting. Interesting how that would go versus recruit squad, especially down this roadway. I think that might be a good buy for Flapajak. And he's also capping the western point now. So interesting play by Pringles. He's got an assault squad, recruit squad, then recruit squad, then another one, I think. And let's see how it works in his favor, just having the numbers on the enemy, maybe forcing the MD to pin down, but it looks like he's ready for a shootout if he manages to move a bit to the left. We have some juicy nom-nom low hit point units to take out. Let's have a look at this. Type 99 slaughter takes out two. That's losing much of his own health. These guys have poor accuracy, takes out four, and has already now made its money's worth, around 50 MP's worth, I guess 55 MP, definitely takes out the whole squad, and he's already made his money's worth. And another recruit squad from Mr. Pringles down the center. Interesting play once again. This is strange, just running straight into the fire of the machine gunner. Playing, maybe he's trying new tactics, I don't know, but this is not the usual type of tactic I see from Mr. Pringles. There's actually, from my knowledge, not a huge buff, or no buff at all to recruits, in fact, and no changes to the World at War and default, basically, that would grant the strategy of spamming militias compared to previously. So I don't know what's going on. There's another militia squad for Mr. Pringles once again, and this time backing it up with a Blackwatch. So trying to get the numbers on, and no chance now with the flak, 20mm by Flapajak, controlling the center point. And now Mr. Pringles has pretty much been stopped in his tracks for sure now with that. Before, even though with the MG, now more so with the 20mm out by Flapajak, as he's got a recruit squad coming to the right. AT rifle as well from Flapajak. So what can Mr. Pringles get? He definitely needs some sort of tank. I'm guessing he's waiting for that to happen. Meantime, he's pushing on the left, trying to get some grenades off. The 20mm does have some range over this area as well, and it's stopping Mr. Pringles in his tracks again. So 11-0, decent lead from Mr. Flapajak, 3-2-3 versus 2-1-1. And I think this is Mr. Pringles showing his rust as well, because he hasn't pretty much played Men of War since the last tournament at all. It's pretty much like me, I haven't touched Men of War, and he hasn't either. So that's probably why, one of the reasons. So here comes the Crusader two pandas. This is the new Crusader. It's got a shitty gun, but it's going to try hunt the 20mm. 20mm is smartly hiding behind the building at very close range. Crusader is in danger of actually getting killed if it goes too close because it's got pretty crappy armor. But now the HE shell is padding to the center. Trying to knock down the house, shooting at the roof, I'm guessing. Nope. He's going to let that be now as the flak is running into safety down the roadway behind that hill. Now, Blackwatch have put some sandbag defenses up. There's still that MG there. No, MG's actually gone. Not sure where that's gone. Now, Flapajak has got the town area as well, pushed up his guys to the stone wall. Pringles sending up some militiamen. Again. That hasn't got a considerable considerable amount of forces to cap the center yet. Gonna try with a few, but sending some guys to the right of the middle just to consolidate his eastern point a bit more. What do we have here? Nothing, just some spotters. No counter yet. Pringles manages to sneaky cap the center. Well, not really sneaky cap, he's actually firing capping. Maybe just militia. Not enough forces from Flapajak. I think two special points should be up. Both of them are pretty slow on the timers, it seems. As he hasn't bought a homeland or Nato. At the other end, Mr. Pringles as well hasn't got a two special point. Unless that was a two special point. I'm not too sure. I think that was a two special point. It could have been. I'm pretty sure I saw a Crusader type vehicle as a 2SP. But Flapajak, I don't think, has bought one yet. Now, 20mm, move to a position which. I think it's acceptable to the two-pounder, but it's got its bottom obscured, so it's hard to hit. Ah, the stone wall as well. It's going to block a shell from the HE. AT rifle from Flapajak. I don't think he'll have a chance, or I think it's possible. Yeah, not possible to penetrate the Crusader AA at all. Pringles coming in with his squad. Looks like he's actually capped below this hill. So it's a very good position, as you know, below the hill. Can ambush the guys as soon as they pop out the top. And it makes that Chinu now a bit paranoid. These guys are just militiamen and riflemen, so they don't have the 80 grenades, but now he's forced to just wait a bit till his infantry clears out the position. Coming out with the Black Watch. Got 80 rifle there as well. Takes out the riflemen. There isn't many troops left at all, so we shouldn't have any problems now if he just charges in. Just playing a little bit safe. 20mm moving to the left. And what was that? Oh, Crusader, hey, 76mm. So that's the howitzer. I think that's the two special point. That's just a MP buy. I don't know if Flapajak has actually bought a 2MP. That doesn't look like the... Oh, that's the home guard. Looks like, yeah, that's the home... Is it the home guard? No, it's not, because they're not recruits. These guys are just normal guys. This is not the home guard. 20mm decrued. Now recrued. 76. Not able to dispatch it yet. Chinu gonna take the long route, because he's not sure. He still hasn't dared to venture below that hill. So now Flapajak is just gonna go the long route. And in fact, may even be the better route, because it's a bit safer, a bit further away. No 50-50s on the two-pounder, and you get the further shot where the gun can easily penetrate and easily takes it out, goes into a ball of flame, and here comes another shot to the 76mm. 76mm wants to fight back. Perhaps he can penetrate it with his HE shell. I'm not sure he can. Boom. Oh, takes out the other one quite easily in succession, and there's two Crusader AAs dead in almost the same position. One can be repaired though. That's a double strike on Pringles. Flapajak taking the lead in kill counts. 130661 to 661. And still in the lead in flags, and we'll take the flag now. Sending his Blackwatch over the hill. Sorry, not Blackwatch, his regular squad with machine gunners. Plus AT rifle guy capping the flag, interesting. Half track by from Mr. Pringles, just gonna come left to clear it. Chinu though in a good position to support. Can quite easily take a few one shot perhaps, and does so quite easily. Commandos coming out. This must be the three special points from Pringles. Comes to the Piat. Oh, let's see it go. Mr. Pringles running in. much luck. The guys in the backfield not supporting well. AT rifle on its own. Got to fight off a few guys before it gets there. Kills the AT infantry of Flapajak though. Sounds like they're perpetually reloading. And struggling to kill this lone rifleman. Chinu still lobbing HE shells over, trying to get kills on those expensive commandos. A 50 cal. Oh, 50 cal knocks down this wall. I think killed one of the guys. His own guys. But Flapajak very sparse on infantry now. Chinu playing safe and now withdrawing in the hill without infantry support. Perhaps. No, he's not. Center, now going back to Mr. Pringles, 21 to 13. Grenade. Wow. Very, very little uncooked grenade there. Took like ages to explode. And no one capping now. It's been decapped. Not much infantry out from Flapajak in the center. Pringles definitely has the majority as a two Lewis guns here, another Black Watch Shadow Lewis gun over there. One lone Type 99 here. Oh, one back over here as well. Ooh, but the mortar is out in a great position. We'll be able to support the center and dispatch all these people behind the sandbags. There's a juicy target right there. Attack ground right over here. And I think Flapajak now is going to try to finish off that Crusader, perhaps. And I think it's been shot at. Ooh, nice shot, Mr. Pringles, expander. Bam. In a very badly positioned Chinu. Side exposed and now finished off by that expander, no longer to be repaired. Oh, there you go. So Flapajak did finish off that Crusader. Knocks off the turret with an AT grenade. 150mm! Oh, that's the juicy shot I was talking about. Takes out two MGs plus change. Now, this is where the mortar will start doing its worth. 20mm now is venturing out to play as well. And it may even be a 3-cap falling out with the paratroopers. Well, this is not paratroopers, this is even worse. This is SNLF, even worse for Pringles, I mean. And it may even mean a 3-cap. What's he got over here? We've got a Crusader again. 76mm howitzer. Decent gun to have on this map. Can hide behind his own healing support, but it's not as good or accurate as the 150mm infantry support, in my opinion. Oh, mortar just takes out his own guys. Wow. That was a horrible shot. And I think this 150mm mortar is in such a low position that that 76 could not hit. Panning in the center, some SNLF capping, one guy in one of the, what do you call these things, craters. 180 infantry. Here comes Mr. Pringles now with an assault, 20mm styles. Here comes the infantry strolling in. No anti-tank weaponry from Mr. Flapajak. Should allow Pringles to get this flag easily if he just takes out those two SNLF. And he's going for the flak instead. Just decoying it now. And perhaps a follow-up with the rifleman to throw a grenade on there. Flapajak frantically coming with SNLF just to protect that mortar. It's a bit in jeopardy. Oh, there goes that rifleman. QF3. Going to try get a side shot perhaps on that mortar from here. Being very aggressive. Two SNLF soldiers right over there. Still not found. QF3 trying to fire at it. One left. Good, it's got it. Two MGs are down, but here's a Chi-Ha. Oh, it's the Banzai call. The Banzai is out. Let's see how he goes. Oh, tracks on. QF. Oh, takes out one Chi-Ha. Here comes the other Chi-Ha. Oh, takes out the Crusader from the side. And oh, the QF. Crusader QF. Oh, Chi-Ha gets piatted right over somewhere. So that Banzai kind of failed. Killed at least the most pressing issue, which was at 20 mil. Now this is actually a sitting duck. I think it's tracked, right? Yeah, this is tracked. Lots of infantry. Oh no, the Pringles has got militia only though. A few mortars will say we'll finish those militias quite easily. We're landing right over here. And it can quite easily push an assault. 20 mil still firing and it actually double tracked it. Now this is definitely sitting duck for a long time. And there's a Chinook from Flapajak. We'll easily put this away. QF tried to take it out. Not sure if it can. It definitely is not hitting its mark, so you don't know. So many misses there, not the most accurate gun as we can see. And there goes that other Crusader. So four Crusaders down from Mr.Pringles. And another one out, and this is the two-pounder one. What? He's crazy. Mr.Pringles is crazy. I don't know what he's buying here. This is just nonsense. Two-pounder gun, this range, Chinook can just take you out right now. I think Flapajak realizes this, and this is what's going to come out. Boom. Oh no, he's going to play safe. That Chinook is really playing safe. It got tracked by something. Must have been that Chinook, but should be an easy put away. Unfortunately, that Chinook is being so inaccurate. Boom! Easy shot. Well, easy put away. In fact, if it just bloody hit on the right QF3 Crusader, or should I say ICS Crusader, whatever that stands for, is now being repaired. Recruits coming in. 20mm from Flapajak. Ooh. Decrew those, or kill those repairers. And going for the 3 cap. 47 to 13, Mr.Pringles is in the shit. 3,000 score to 2,450. Kill wise as well, Chinook top scoring. Both Chinooks doing very well in this game. Very cost effective tank. An all econ for Mr.Pringles. Doesn't have much of the way of protecting that Olicon if it comes out. It may be too late as a 3 cap is on when Mr.Pringles doesn't even have any forces in any of the flags to make any sort of take back. Olicon will take a while to get there. Once it gets there, probably be score 70 or 80. And when it gets there, the mortar even can kill it. So it's not looking good to Pringles at all. He needed a Crusader AA 20mm to stay alive in that area and somehow take out a Chinook when he was trying to counter it. But with that mortar there, that pretty much nullifies any sort of emplacement Mr.Pringles can bring. All Econ, 6-pounder, all that is useless now. And this All Econ will just fire off a few shots and then soon it'll be useless. And the mortar from Flapajak already turning around to face it off. And here comes a nice toasted sandwich for Mr.Pringles. Definitely showing his rustiness. Just the way he's buying is interesting. I don't know. His strategy is a bit strange with the militia squad, especially in the open, charging like that. Maybe he's just trying some strategies in the group stages. 20mm is down, as expected. And 68 to 13, I suspect there is nothing more Pringles can do. Jeez, there's a mortar pounding on the other side, and that's this whole eastern front has been wiped out of infantry. No spawning for Mr. Pringles. Perhaps this is a white flag from the Finnish ex-master, I'll say. Oh, there's no such thing as ex-master. Let's leave it as master. People lose their touch. He's still as a master. One of the best players of all time, most definitely. Flapajak is definitely smiling right now. Not too many people can say they've taken out Pringles. In a tournament, there's only one other person that's taken out Pringles before this, and that was Tedessa in the last one. But at Pringles Prime, nobody took him out. Only Hansi got close, winning a game in the best out of three, but never being able to close it off. And here's the half-track run from Mr. Pringles, gets away by the RPG. And SAS coming in. Boom! Still alive, the RPG cannot kill some more. Oh, it doesn't matter, Flapajak wins, takes out Mr. Pringles, who is shown to be rusty. So, anyway guys, the game 2, I don't have the replay there, it actually failed on them for some reason. But Flapajak also won that as well, so Well done to Flapajak. He's doing well in Group B so far.